Hi students, welcome back to all four e-learning chemistry classes. Today we are going to start session 21 and I am going to start a new topic in this session, that is redox reactions, the chemical reactions in which both oxidation and as well as reduction takes place are known as redox reactions. First of all, we have to go through the detailed discussion about oxidation and reduction, and then we will go for the concept of redox reactions. Let me explain what exactly the oxidation is and what exactly the reduction is. Note down, students. Oxidation, I am writing here, and a reduction on right side. Oxidation can be considered in different ways. One, addition of oxygen. Addition of oxygen or you can also represent removal of hydrogen. Removal of hydrogen or loss of electrons. Loss of electrons. Increase in oxidation state. I am just writing OS, oxidation state. Any one of these four can be considered as oxidation. Addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen, or loss of electrons, or increase in oxidation state of an element. All these can be simply considered as the process called oxidation. And coming to reduction, opposite to that, addition of, just I am writing element here, students, please note it down, addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen, just I have written element, removal of oxygen or gain of electrons or decrease in oxidation state, OS I am writing, decrease in oxidation state. Addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen or gain of electrons or decrease in oxidation state. Any one of all these four can be considered as reduction. So, this is different forms of oxidation process and oxidation reaction and reduction reaction. If both the things will occur, then you can call those chemical reactions as redox reactions, because in those chemical reactions, the two chemical processes, oxidation and as well as reduction, both will occur within the same chemical reaction. So, that's why these reactions are said to be redox reactions. Please note it down and I will continue. Okay, students, let us discuss the redox reaction concept by taking one example. Please note it down. Zinc on reaction with copper sulfate aqueous solution gives copper and zinc sulfate aqueous. if you go for the calculation of oxidation numbers, zinc in the uncombined state, the oxidation state of any element in its uncombined state should be considered as zero. Here we know for entire sulfate it is minus 2. We have already discussed that very in detail in the previous session while discussing about oxidation states. So simply you can write for copper as plus 2, because for entire sulfate it is minus 2 charge on the ion. Here copper is uncombined state, it is 0. Similarly zinc sulfate, so zinc oxidation state is plus 2. If you observe this reaction with respect to the oxidation states for the elements zinc and copper, the oxidation states have been changed. For zinc, the oxidation state is changed from 0 to plus 2. 0 to plus 2. It means the oxidation state of zinc is increasing. Just now I have discussed about the process of oxidation. Increase in oxidation state should be considered as oxidation. So here I am writing, no problem. Increase in oxidation state. So you have to consider this as oxidation. If you observe for copper, here the oxidation state of copper is decreasing from plus 2 to 0. So we have to consider this as reduction. Why? Because reduction decrease in oxidation state. So in this particular chemical reaction, both oxidation reduction takes place. Oxidation occurs on zinc, reduction takes place on copper. So you can call this reaction as redox reaction, and you can simply write this reaction in some other form also. Let me give that approach also. Please write zinc. This is ionic compound, so you can write ions plus sulfate ion gives rise to copper solid, Zn2+ aqueous plus sulfate ion aqueous. If you observe this reaction, I have written ionic form of reaction. This is molecular form of reaction, this ionic form of reaction, where some ions can get be cancelled, can be get cancelled on both sides. Such type of ions which can be cancelled on both sides can be called as, here I am writing the name, spectator ions. Here the spectator ions are sulfate ions, because those two can be cancelled on both sides. So remaining equation, zinc solid, simply you can write Cu2+ aqueous and Cu solid and Zn2+ aqueous. This is called skeletal equation. Skeletal equation, which contains majorly ions by cancelling out the spectator ions on both sides. The remaining equation simply you can call it as a skeletal equation. You can represent the same redox reaction in this form also. In this form also. Here, I want to explain one more concept also, students. Please write down first of all. Zinc is undergoing oxidation. At the same time, copper is undergoing reduction. Zinc is undergoing oxidation, losing of electrons. Copper is undergoing reduction, gaining those electrons. Here, copper is gaining electrons because zinc is giving those electrons by undergoing oxidation. Zinc is giving or losing electrons for copper to get reduced. Zinc is giving electrons for Cu2+ to get reduced. That's why zinc can be called as reducing agent. Here, Cu2+ is accepting electrons. It means gaining of electrons. It means it is taking away electrons from zinc. The reason for the oxidation of zinc is Cu2+. So this can be called as oxidizing agent. Okay. To understand in the more efficient way, I will split this equation into two half reactions. Right. First, oxidation I am writing. Zinc solid gives rise to Zn2+ aqueous. Similarly, I can write here Cu2+ aqueous gives rise to Cu solid. This is oxidation half reaction. This is reduction half reaction. Oxidation means loss of electrons. How many electrons are lost here? 2 electrons. Here addition of electrons. Now you can understand very easily about what I have discussed just now with you. Zinc is losing electrons and finally the electrons are useful for the reduction of Cu2+. So zinc can act as reducing agent. Here Cu2+ is accepting electrons, so that can be called as oxidizing agent because it is accepting electrons from lost by zinc. So that's why we can simply give the statements like this. An oxidizing agent can easily undergo reduction. A reducing agent can easily undergo oxidation. First of all, you please write it down and then I will go for a detailed discussion about this once again. This you can write it as, note down students, oxidation half reaction. This is reduction half RCN reaction. Just note it down, then I will continue and I will explain once again what is oxidizing agent, reducing agent, and everything I will discuss once again. You please finish off this. Okay, students, see, here this is oxidation half reaction, OHR, just now I have given, simply I am writing, this is reduction half reaction, RHR, leave it. Here, loss of electrons, and this is addition of electrons, we know. Here I am writing oxidizing agent, which can be also called as simply as oxidant. Next, I am writing here reducing agent, or simply you can also write it as reductant. Note down, students. reductant. Here in this particular redox reaction, oxidizing agent, it means opposite to oxidation. Oxidation means loss of electrons. If a substance is there ready to accept those electrons, then only it can lose electrons. Here the substance is gaining electrons. So the process occurring here is reduction. Reduction. The reason for this reduction is that substance which is giving electrons to this one. So substance which readily lose electron can act as a good reducing agent. Here zinc is more ready to lose electrons. That's why those electrons can be added here. The process takes place here is reduction. The responsibility for this reduction is zinc. So here reducing agent or reductant, you can simply take it as zinc in this particular redox reaction. So here oxidizing agent, it means it is the reason for the losing of electrons process there, oxidation. There oxidation is going on. It means electrons are losing. Means I have to be more ready to accept those electrons. Okay, then only oxidation takes place there. So that's why oxidizing agent should easily undergo reduction. Ready to accept those electrons, then immediately the oxidation takes place there. So I should be more ready to accept electrons. So then only the oxidation will occur easily on that element. So I can be called as oxidizing agent or oxidant. Here oxidizing agent is Cu plus 2. So here my final conclusion is, don't get confused, students, very important. Oxidation and oxidizing agent, both are different. Oxidation means loss of electrons. Oxidizing agent means substance which is more ready to accept electrons. It means substance which can easily undergo reduction. So oxidizing agent always undergoes reduction. Undergoes reduction. Whereas reducing agent always undergoes oxidation. Please note it down, students. Don't get confused. Once again, I am repeating. Oxidizing agent or oxidant will always ready to undergo reduction. Reducing agent or reductant always ready to undergo oxidation. Don't forget about this very, very important area. Please note it down. Then I will continue. Okay, students, let me explain with some examples. KMnO4, potassium permanganate. K2Cr2O7, potassium dichromate. KMnO4 in acidic medium always changes into manganese plus 2 ion, whereas potassium dichromate is chromium always changes into chromium plus 3 ion in the reactions. If you calculate the oxidation state of manganese here, it is plus 7. Already I did all these calculations. Here for chromium it is plus 6. What is happening here? Plus 7 to plus 2. The oxidation state of manganese is decreasing from plus 7 to plus 2. You can call this process as decrease in oxidation number should be called as reduction. Similarly, here also it is decrease in oxidation number from plus 6 to plus 3. So here also you have to call this as reduction. So here manganese and chromium are undergoing reduction. So these two can be called as oxidants. these two can be called as oxidants or oxidizing agents. Oxidants or oxidizing agents. So, just now we have discussed oxidants or oxidizing agent should undergo reduction because they have to gain electrons. So, they are responsible for the losing of electrons there. So, that is why you can call these two as simply as oxidants, oxidants. Chlorine, if it is changes into chloride, say for example, this is 0, this is minus 1. This also decrease in oxidation number. So, chlorine can be used as oxidizing agent because decrease in oxidation number again. So, reduction. So, it can also be used as oxidation, oxidizing agent. So, in this way, in a given redox reactions, we can easily identify which is undergoing oxidation, which is undergoing reduction, and which is oxidizing agent or oxidant, and which is reducing agent or reductant. Oxidizing agent should always undergo reduction, whereas reducing agent will always undergo oxidation, always undergo oxidation. Say for example, Fe plus 2 to Fe plus 3, plus 2 plus 3 increase in oxidation state. So, it is called oxidation process. So, it can be used as reductant or reducing agent, reductant or reducing agent. Like that, we can easily identify in a given redox reaction which is oxidation and reduction, which is oxidant and as well as reductant. So, in this way, we can get some questions based on the redox reactions basic concept. And now, after finishing of this, I will go for types of redox reactions. Please note it down, I will go for types of redox reactions. Now, let me discuss about the types of redox reactions. Let me discuss the first type. Chemical combination reactions. Write down, friends. Chemical combination reactions. RCNS, just now I have written. Don't get confused. Reactions. Chemical combination reactions. I will simply magnesium plus oxygen gives magnesium oxide, combination of two and gets one compound, chemical combination. Nitrogen, hydrogen, ammonia, combination of two elements on reaction directly with each other and forming a compound, chemical combination reaction. In which way it belongs to redox reactions? Now, that is our discussion. Magnesium here, elemental form in the uncombined state, 0. Oxygen is also molecular form, homoatomic molecule, so for that one is also 0. Magnesium alkaline earth metal plus 2. So neutral molecule, so oxygen is automatically minus 2. Now, if you take this, magnesium is changing its oxidation state from 0 to plus 2. increase. So you can call that as oxidation. Here oxygen, I am writing from here to here for clarity. See, observe, 0 to minus 2, decrease in oxidation state. So you can call that as reduction. So in this particular chemical combination reaction, oxidation occurs on magnesium and reduction takes place on oxygen. Both the things are going on, so you can call this as redox reaction. Even though it is a chemical combination reaction, you can also call that as redox reaction. Similarly, if you come to this example, nitrogen and hydrogen both are in homoatomic molecular form, 0 and 0. Here, for hydrogen, plus 1, because it is non-metal nitrogen. For nitrogen, if you calculate, minus 3. Students, I have already told you very clearly, while teaching oxidation states, one should be in a position to assign oxidation state the moment you see the compound. You have to practice like that. You need a vigorous practice in oxidation states, then you can easily assign oxidation numbers and you can easily fix which is oxidation, which is reduction, and everything you can easily fix. Don't forget about that. Right. Here, hydrogen 0 to plus 1 increase in oxidation state. So it is called as oxidation. Coming to nitrogen, decreasing from 0 to minus 3. So you have to name this as a reduction. Both oxidation, reduction. So you can call this reaction as a redox reaction. A redox reaction. Here, now tell me which is oxidant and reductant in both of these examples. Okay, I will write for this equation left side and I will write for this equation on right side. Let me write oxidant, reductant, oxidant or oxidizing agent. Oxidant should undergo reduction. Which is undergoing reduction? Oxygen. Yeah, simply you can write oxygen. Reductant should easily undergo oxidation. Which is undergoing oxidation? Magnesium. Simply you can identify. Similarly, for the second reaction, please note it down. I will write on the other side of the board. Please concentrate. For this reaction, oxidant, a reductant. Oxidant should easily undergo reduction. Which is undergoing reduction? Nitrogen. Here, reductant should easily undergo oxidation. This is the oxidation. So, hydrogen. So, in this way, the moment you see the redox reaction, if you are able to calculate oxidation numbers in the perfect way, then immediately you can fix which is oxidation, which is reduction, which is oxidant and which is reductant. All the things we can easily decide. Note it down, then I will go for next type of redox reaction. Okay, students, let me go for the next type. Chemical, write down, decomposition reactions. Just RCNS, I am writing, chemical decomposition reactions. Let me explain with example. This is potassium chlorate. On decomposition gives potassium chloride and oxygen. So this is the balanced equation. For this equation, if you calculate the oxidation numbers, for oxygen it is minus 2, for potassium it is plus 1, wherever it is, no change because it is alkali metal fixed. So for chlorine, if you calculate, it is plus 5. Please calculate it once. Plus 5 plus 6 minus 6 equals to 0. That's why I have written as plus 5. Leave it. Come to right side products. Here chlorine is minus 1, whereas oxygen is 0. First, let me write down for chlorine. Chlorine oxidation state is changing from plus 5 to minus 1, decreasing. So, you should call this as reduction. Similarly, if you go for oxygen, here it is minus 2, on the products side it is 0. Increase in oxidation number, you should call this as oxidation. Here I am writing again, oxidizing agent or oxidant, reducing agent or reductant. Students, please fix. Oxidant should undergo reduction. Here, which is undergoing reduction? Chlorine. Reductant should undergo oxidation. So, nothing but oxygen. Leave it. Next, one more example. This is also decomposition reaction. On to physical state also, you can write down, friends, no problem. Solid. Carbon dioxide and oxygen gases, we know very well, leave it. Let me calculate. Calcium plus 2, it is alkaline earth metals, no need of calculation. Anywhere you find alkaline earth metal, blindly you can fix that oxidation state as plus 2. No discussion about that. No change. For oxygen, minus 2, for carbon it is plus 4, if you do the calculations. Here for oxygen minus 2, here in this also oxygen minus 2, for this carbon dioxide, carbon is also plus 4, because x plus 2 into minus 2 equals 0, plus 4. No doubt it is chemical decomposition reaction. Is there any change in the oxidation state of any element? No. Alkaline earth metal, calcium, no change, leave it. Carbon, also no change, plus 4, plus 4. Oxygen is also not having any change with respect to its oxidation state. Minus 2 on both sides. Look at the heading. Chemical decomposition reactions under the types of redox reactions. Of course, the first one is decomposition reaction, no doubt, because oxidation reduction very clearly we have observed here. No oxidation, no reduction. The oxidation state of all the elements did not change in this reaction. So you not supposed to call this as a redox reaction. It is only decomposition reaction. It is not a redox reaction. So, what is our final conclusion? All decomposition reactions need not be redox. I am writing. All decomposition reactions, RCNS, all decomposition reactions need not be redox. There is no rule that all decomposition reactions are redox. No. The redox reaction, decomposition reactions may or may not be redox. The decomposition reactions which proceed with both oxidation and reduction can be called as redox decomposition reactions. Otherwise, even though they belong to the category of decomposition reactions, they never under the category of redox reactions. So that's why I have written here, all decomposition reactions need not be redox. Note it down. Let me go for next type. Displacement reactions. Displacement reactions. One element is going to displace another element from its compound. That's why these reactions are named as displacement reactions. Let me explain with example. Right, see here, magnesium on reaction with zinc sulfate, it displacing zinc from this sulfate and instead of zinc it is going. So zinc is, magnesium is displacing zinc from zinc sulfate. Magnesium is displacing zinc from zinc sulfate. That's why this is called a chemical displacement reaction. Let me explain how it is a redox reaction. Magnesium elemental form zinc. For zinc sulfate, you can simply write it as, for zinc as plus 2, because for total sulfate it is minus 2. Here zinc is 0. Here magnesium becomes plus 2. So simply you can say this is oxidation. Increase in oxidation state, and whereas this is reduction in oxidation state plus 2 to 0, so decrease, so simply you can call it as a reduction. So you can call this particular displacement reaction, both oxidation and as well as reduction takes place. That's why it can also be called as a redox reaction, even though it belongs to a chemical displacement reactions in the category. So this is also come under the category of one type of redox reaction where chemical displacement takes place. I'll give one more example. When fluorine gas is passed through aqueous potassium chloride solution, you will get chlorine gas if you observe this reaction carefully. Here fluorine is displacing chlorine from its compounds while this gas is passing through this. Fluorine has that capacity to displace chlorine from its compounds in aqueous solution state. This is displacement reaction where chlorine is displaced by fluorine. And let me conclude how this become a redox reaction. Here fluorine F2 monoatomic molecules, so oxidation state of both the fluorines is 0. Here potassium plus 1, so chlorine minus 1. Here chlorine homoatomic molecule, diatomic molecule 0. Here for fluorine it is minus 1. Here fluorine is oxidation state decreasing here. So undergo reduction, whereas oxidation state of chlorine is increased from minus 1 to 0. So it is called as oxidation. It is called as oxidation. So in this particular reaction also, both oxidation and reduction takes place. Okay. Let me discuss about oxidant and reductant also in this reaction. Just to explain once again to you. Oxidant, reductant. I have already explained for 4 or 5 equations. Once again, I am repeating, just concentrate. Oxidant or oxidizing agent should easily undergo reduction. Here, where the reduction is going on? Fluorine. So, fluorine is oxidizing agent here, because it is undergoing reduction. Reductant or reducing agent, that should undergo oxidation. Which is undergoing oxidation here? Chlorine. So, here oxidizing agent is fluorine, whereas reducing agent is chlorine. So, please note it down, students. Then I will go for next type of redox reactions. Before going to the next type, let us discuss some important points. Which type of ion or which type of oxidation state of an element can act as oxidant or can act as reductant or can act as both as well as oxidant or reductant? Please concentrate, students. If you take chlorine, chlorine can exhibit -1, 0, +1, +3, +5, and +7. The same element can exhibit all these oxidation states. I will just give examples. Cl minus, Cl2, 0. ClO minus, hypochlorite ion. ClO2 minus, chlorite ion. ClO3 minus, chlorate ion. ClO4 minus, perchlorate ion. Chloride, you know, this is hypochlorite Te. This is simply chlorite, whereas this is chlorate, and last one is perchlorate. You see, one should know the naming of all these radicals. Okay. These are the different forms of compounds of chlorine and elemental chlorine here, molecular form, possessing different oxidation states. Let me take chloride ion. This is all the data. Please note it down fast, students. Then now, let me take chloride ion, say. That is the least possible oxidation state of chlorine. Least possible oxidation state of chlorine. Okay. Please note it down. Least possible oxidation state. So, it can change to 0 because oxidation state is -1. It can increase its oxidation number to 0 or +1 or +3 or +5 or +7. So, it always undergo oxidation only, because this is the least possible oxidation state. So, the only chance is it can increase its oxidation state from this -1 to 0 or +1 or +3 up to maximum +7. It means this is particularly always undergo oxidation only, because increase in oxidation state is oxidation. Right? Now, it always undergo oxidation only. So, it always acts as reductant only. It can never act as, it cannot act as oxidant, because the further reduction in the further decrease in the oxidation state is not possible. So chlorine has minimum oxidation state, minimum possible oxidation state, or least possible oxidation state is only -1. Wherever it is involving in the chemical reaction, it will change, it can change its oxidation number from 0 to +7 only. That means increase, that means the process is oxidation. That's why it can act as a reductant only. Least possible oxidation state. So, not only for chlorine, for any element which is present in least possible oxidation state, always undergo oxidation only and always act as a reductant only. Suppose if I take ClO4 minus, where oxidation state is +7, this is maximum, because chlorine belongs to 7th group, no exceptions, maximum possible oxidation state is +7 only. I am writing maximum possible oxidation state. So, chlorine is present in +7. The only way involving in the reaction is either it may decrease to +5 or +3 or +1 or 0 or -1. So, only way is it should decrease its oxidation number. So, always undergo oxidation only. Always undergo reduction only. Always undergo reduction only. So, act as oxidant only. Act as oxidant only. So, among all the species of chlorine, chloride ion always act as reductant only because it can undergo oxidation only. Don't get confused, students. Whereas chlorine present in +7 in perchlorate ion always undergo reduction only to decrease its oxidation number. So that's why it have to act as oxidant only, because easily undergo reduction means it can act as a reducing agent. So these two are fixed. Suppose if the element is present in moderate oxidation state, say for example +3 can be changed to these three or can be changed through these two. So in such oxidation state, that can act as either oxidant as well as reductant. Both the things it can be done by that particular species where the element is present in moderate oxidation state. Please note down, students, this is very, very important approach that one should know. And I am going to conclude this session with this aspect, very important aspect regarding redox reactions are concerned. And in the next session, I will continue the types of redox reactions. Some more types are there, very, very important, even the point of competitive examination you, and I will continue that in the next session. Please note it down. Thank you.